The definition of obesity is based on body mass index. Generally, you can obtain this from a table or calculator. Greater than 30 kilograms per meter squared would be considered the definition of obesity. Though there are certain flaws in that screening for obesity, in that the body mass index doesn't take into account the gender or age of the patient, or if their extra pounds are related to increased fat or lean muscle, or you know their level of fitness. Obesity is a global epidemic. It's estimated that over a third of patients in the United States are classified as obese, and more than two-thirds are overweight or obese. And the increase in, there's been a significant increase in the last 25 years from 20 to 25% to 35% incidence of obesity. And it's become quite an epidemic among childhood and teenage years. There are certain metabolic and physiological changes that are associated with obesity that increase the risk of cardiovascular disease. Some of these are insulin resistance, hyperinsulinemia, increasing the incidence of diabetes type 2, hypertension, also increasing wall thickness of the left ventricle, left ventricular hypertrophy, and there's been also increased endothelial problems with endothelial function that may predispose to worsening coronary artery disease. In addition to looking at body mass index, it's important to assess the waist circumference, so that in a male, you would like to see the waist circumference of less than 40 inches, and this would be a direct horizontal measurement across the iliac crest. And in a female, this waist circumference should be less than 35%. Because what we've found is actually that may be a greater predictor of increased risk of heart disease, since they have increased visceral fat. And this is not the subcutaneous fat, but the deeper fat in the abdominal wall that oftentimes involves the liver as well as the heart. And we've determined that visceral fat may release certain hormones that are pro-inflammatory that may accelerate the process of atherosclerosis. Many men have a redistribution of their weight around the middle, and we describe a so-called apple configuration where they tend to have more weight around their middle than in their thighs. And these are the patients that tend to have increased visceral fat. To maintain an ideal body weight has several positive benefits, one being that it will lower blood pressure, so that if you're obese and lose weight, there can be a significant decrease in blood pressure over time as you continue to lose weight. There's less insulin resistance. Your lipid profile improves, so that your LDL, or so-called bad cholesterol, may get better, as well as your good cholesterol rising and your triglycerides being decreased. Your heart is not having to carry such a load, so there's less stress on the heart, less chance that the heart becomes thickened or that you develop congestive heart failure, which is a problem that is a definite increased risk in obese patients. I tell my patients that it's important to know their numbers. So they should know what their body mass index and waist circumference is. They should know their blood pressure, their fasting blood sugar, their lipid profile. All those things are very important, as well as leading a healthy lifestyle, which would be a diet that is a Mediterranean type diet that's high in fruits and vegetables and grains and beans, and using olive oil, as well as consuming nuts, fish and chicken in somewhat limited portions, and very little red meat. Also, I encourage patients to be doing some form of aerobic exercise, so that they're walking 30 to 45 minutes, or using an elliptical or bike, doing that most days of the week. There's an increased risk of abnormalities of the heart function, such as the filling aspect and the pumping aspect of the left ventricle. Also, there's an increased risk of rhythm problems with the heart, particularly atrial fibrillation. And sleep apnea is associated with obesity. And sleep apnea has a very important impact on heart health as well as blood pressure.